Because a lot of people harass me and said love me and make jokes about it, the color and everything, right? And for me, having this place with that picture that you're looking, everyone's looking at this, it took me a while. Yes. So it's very significant.
I like you putting on the cover of Afro Historia, because that is your, anybody who looks at it sees an image of themselves, those of us who are African and who are Black women. And, you know, the story that you just told is the reason why Oprah Winfrey is on the cover of every single one of her issues, right? Because she doesn't see herself. She didn't see herself, right? And for those of us who are like big fat and know what it is to walk down the street, whether it's in San Juan or in Guadalajara or New York City, and be harassed for walking down the street and you're just trying to get to where you go, I thank you for that. I thank you for, on behalf of all of us, who can see ourselves in your way. You did a tremendous job. This was a tremendous piece today. And I thank you. I thank you all your ranking for inspiring you. And I wanted to ask both about the naming practices, whether it's the names, the names of those artists, and the names of the Odishas, the names of the Rabarabas, right? How you work with names, why it is important for you to name in your work.
I teach a class, and some of the classes goes back to the slave period. And we revise how, the masters rebaptize the slaves. And it's incredible, maybe your name is, your African name is Charlie or EDC, and they decide, okay, you're going to be Teresa or Maria or Juana. Canela, but with the explicit desire of this humanizing, taking out your soul, they do that consistently with other things, their traditional practices of cooking, or the traditional practices of religion, etc. But they started at the names, for the names. So I don't know how powerful it is to go back to those names. Those names that I just used in my keynote address, I want to thank you. I want to thank Raj, and I want to thank Bobby, and Julia, because they sent me this wonderful citizen book, An American Living of Claudia Rankine. Without them, leading me to embrace that look of Claudia, I would imagine my life. It touched me in ways very, very deep. And some of the names were victims of police brutality. And I read all of them in the book, but the ones that moved me more were the ones that were females, the women. Because sometimes when I read some of the pages of the book, and then go back to make research more. And some of these stories include abusers as other females, and that breaks my heart. Because we are feminists, and we keep fighting for equality and rights, and knowing that some of these women, they don't even care about that. I mean, they go back and go to the side of the oppressor. Mm-hmm. It's very sad when you realize that. So that is where these names come from. Also, the artist, I am going to the library this morning, and even including the beautiful exhibition internet, I can look at some of them. For example, the Santa Maria simulation, it was very powerful because it's something like having her there, you're asking her questions and she's answering the questions, but she's not there. But it's, you know, that simulation is feeding from the thoughts and the things that she did when she was alive. So that one, that's why I keep repeating Sandra Land, because she was one of the victims that most affected me.
Yeah. I think also it's important